Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome. Happy Memorial Day to all of you. I'm glad that you're here. This is certainly a holiday, and we can do whatever we want today. For the most part, people can do whatever they want. I'm glad that you chose to be here today to remember those who have so valiantly given their lives for our country, and for those who have served who are here today. And also, today is a special day because we celebrate the Feast of the Visitation today. So Mary's visit with her cousin Elizabeth. So we celebrate both of those great events today. So I'm glad you're here. And I'm glad that you took the time and made the effort to be here today of all days. So thank you for being here. And let's pray for those who have served us, and let's pray for each other this morning as well.
And now please stand and join with us in singing America the Beautiful, number 735.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of Jesus, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather in the name of the Lord, let us call to mind our sins as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who while the Blessed Virgin Mary was carrying your Son in her womb, inspired her to visit Elizabeth, grant us, we pray, that faithful to the promptings of the Spirit, we may magnify your greatness with the Virgin Mary at all times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Zephaniah. Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, "Fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord, your God, is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you as one sings at festivals." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord! The earth is full of your creatures.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your Spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. Your words, O Lord, give joy to my heart. Your teaching is light to my eyes. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out
and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, this is somewhat of a significant feast day for us in the Catholic Church, that we celebrate Mary's meeting with her cousin Elizabeth. Yet today in this country, we celebrate Memorial Day. And I can't help but think that there are many parallels between the trip that Mary made to visit her cousin and what those who have died for our country did as well. The trip that Mary made was very perilous. She made it on her own. And she went through many areas that were considered to be very dangerous. So she risked her life to visit her cousin. Plus, she was expecting a child, right? So what she did was way out of the ordinary. What the people who have served our country have done was way out of the ordinary as well. I'd like to tell you a quick story about one person that I think can certainly relate to Mary's journey. His name is, I'm going to hope I get this right, Father Emil Capone. If you haven't heard of him, it's likely you will sometime in the future. He was a chaplain in World War II and finished his tour of duty. And then came the Korean War in 1950, and he decided to reenlist and be a chaplain in Korea. And in November of 1950, his infantry unit that he was a part of was heavily attacked by the Chinese, and they were instructed to retreat. Well, only about 25% of them were able to escape. And Father Emil, instead of retreating, went out into the front lines, into no man's land. You know what no man's land is, right? And he came to grab the wounded and drag them back to see if he could help them, at great risk to himself, just like what Mary did to visit her cousin Elizabeth. Well, he was captured. And Even in prison as a POW, he strived so mightily to make sure that the other prisoners' needs were met. He gave up his own food. He made sure that whatever he could do, he could help the other men. And about 6 months later, he contracted dysentery and also had pneumonia. And the Koreans, in their warm hearts, put him in a hospital and starved him to death to die. He died on May 23rd in 1951. The men who were in the prison with him, when they were released at the end of the war, had put together scraps of wood for several years, whatever they could find. And they made a cross that was about 4 feet high. They used radio wire to make a crown of thorns. And they presented it to the family after they were released. Since then, Father Amo has had several miracles attributed to him. And that's why I'm saying, I think if you haven't heard his name, you will in the future. He was named a servant of God by Pope John Paul III, or the second, I'm sorry, there is no third, the second. Saint John Paul II. Back in 1993, which means that that was the beginning of his cause for beatification and canonization. And that's still being researched. Those miracles that people have claimed were because of their prayers to Father Emil and his for his intercession are being investigated right now. Let's pray that this man who gave everything to not just serve his country, but to serve his people, those who he was with, can be brought to fruition. Mary risked her life when she said yes. The moment she said yes to the angel Gabriel, her life was at risk. We have to somehow risk our lives for Jesus. Our society has become more and more secular. Every attempt is being made right now to push God out of everything. We can't let that happen, my friends. We have got to stand up to our faith. Not just here. This is a nice, safe environment. We have to stand up to it out there. Father Emil lived his faith by what he did. We also need to live our faith by what we do.
As we gather, let us present our intentions to the Lord our God as we pray.
For all who have served our country, may they know of our great gratitude and care for them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our government leaders, that they will strive to serve the needs of all in their service, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Virgin Mary's example of piety, charity, and love will be lived by each of us as we strive for the heavenly kingdom, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For continued improvement in ending the pandemic and for patience and care for all, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parishioners who have lost their lives serving our country, may they be rewarded for their sacrifice. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may the grace of God be showered upon them for eternity. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intention of this Mass, for the deceased members of the Polish Legion and VFW Post 9677, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving and gracious Lord, we extend to you some of our needs, our challenges, our sufferings, and we ask that you truly be with us in all of them. Lead us on to your kingdom, we pray.
Lord, we ask our prayer.
We ask our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And as the Eucharistic gifts are prepared, we will sing God's Holy Gifts, number 339.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Heavenly Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the grace and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May our offering of this saving sacrifice be acceptable to your majesty, O Lord, as you were pleased to accept the charity of the most blessed mother of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David Ricken, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace with you. Thank you. Peace with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Thy kingdom come, thy earth, thy will.
Let us pray. May your church proclaim your greatness, O Lord, for you have done great things for your faithful. And as St. John the Baptist leapt with joy when he first sensed the hidden presence of Christ, so may your church rejoice to receive in this sacrament the same ever-living Lord who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
We invite you immediately after this Mass over to our military garden for a memorial service. If you would please stay for that, that would be wonderful. I'd like to offer a blessing to our veterans who are assembled here this morning. So if you could please raise your right hand and a blessing to these people who have served us so well. Not you. We're blessing you. So no, not you. God of power and mercy, you destroy war and put down earthly pride. Banish violence from our midst and wipe away our tears, that we may all deserve to be called your sons and daughters. Keep in your mercy those men and women who have died in the cause of freedom, and bring them safely into your kingdom of justice and peace. And please, Lord, bless also those assembled here who have served to defend our freedoms, and keep them always safely in your love. We ask this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
May we pray for our vocation directors, Father Mark Milosevic and Father Adam Bradley. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We pray the prayer to St. Joseph. Good St. Joseph, as you led the Holy Family, watch over our families. Help our family and all families to know and share God's love. In our relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God, the Church. With Mary, raise Jesus the High Priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese.
May our children and grandchildren
hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good St. Joseph, pray for us. We pray the prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him,
we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan, the other evil spirits, who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
And please join us in singing Battle Hymn of the Republic, number 578.
Seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling up the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He hath loosed the fateful lightning.
trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of all before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet. Our God.